Hi everyone, let's take a look at the new NHL website, data website, Edge. NHL Edge has a lot of really cool stuff on it. There's some videos at the top that show you, sort of give you a primer on the graphics, but we're going to get into the data itself. So I want to show you what's in here. Some really cool stuff, but some stuff that I'm sort of trying to figure out. Okay, so there's toggles right at the top. So you can pick the last three seasons. You can pick, I mean, there's no playoffs at the time of this video. There will be in a little while, but no videos right now. And then you can pick your metric. So thank you, Canada and US. Okay, so we're going to scroll down. So you can do skating speed, distance, shot speed, et cetera, et cetera. So I want to scroll down just to show you some of the graphs that they're creating. So here are for the goalies. These are the graphs that they are creating, that they're generating. And so you can select and do all these pull downs for these different areas. And so right here, they're just ranking, right? So which are the best goalies in these different areas of the ice. Now, when you go over here to the main graphic, you can see it's got a grayscale visualization here. And so it's not a diverging chart. It's below average to above average, below being the darker colors, above being the lighter colors. And that's a little strange. I mean, the way, if you were to say to me, make a color palette for a scale that goes from below to above average, I would think I would want to make a diverging palette. But you can also see that they're using just grayscale here. So there's no color being used in the data visualizations, which again is interesting. I mean, you kind of would think that this would change based on maybe the color of the team. But I guess because you can toggle between all of these, the color palette then remains the same, which I guess is nice. So it's not that this is hard to read. It's just kind of an interesting decision. And when I look at these five segments in the legend, is the middle average? Like, it's unclear to me what the average is. Or am I just supposed to say, okay, this is way above average and this is way below average? So that's kind of interesting. All of this, as you can see, except for the logos and the headshots of the players, it's all black and white. It's all grayscale. So, which I find interesting, especially when we go up to the top, when we can do some comparisons. So I'm going to go in here and do a comparison between my Washington Capitals and who we are sort of funny with right now for the, we'll just do teams here. For playoffs right now. So Washington Capitals and the Detroit Red Wings. Now they're going to have similar colors, but as you're going to see, and I'll click here, and we're going to get a team by team comparison. So again, just the logos are the color, and they're just using grayscale within each of these visualizations. Now, I guess one advantage of using the grayscale is that there's no decision, or there's no complicated decision about what colors will be used, right? Because if NHL said, or if the tool said, okay, so for the Capitals, the core color will be red, the core color for the Wings is also going to be red. So having those two on the same graph might be hard to read. Whereas if you say, forget it, we're just going to go grayscale, then you don't have to make that pair by pair determination. So in that sense, I sort of get it that it's simple. These radar charts, you don't really see a lot. So this is kind of nice. You can sort of do these comparisons for these in-depth data. And then you can go down here and you can see some of these comparisons. And the only sort of interactivity is in this time series bar chart, which again, it's skate distance. I mean, unclear to me how much of this is actually useful. but then we get back to these rink maps again, these sort of heat maps by rink, which is kind of fun. And again, the color is still the grayscale. And then they have other ones based on the offensive zone. So you can't really overlay these necessarily, although there's not a ton here, I think, that really necessarily helps, at least from a fan perspective. Maybe from a coach perspective, it's a lot easier. Let's go over to skaters real quick. And we are, of course, going to go down to the Capitals. Now, here's interesting. The way they've sorted the names is based on position. So it's not alphabetical, which is, I think, the way I would want to see it. I mean, I know when I look at hockey box scores, it's defense and then offense, which is how it's arranged here. But if I want to pick up Ovechkin, I have to scroll all the way, you know, like past some of these names, right? So it's kind of like Alex Ovechkin should be at the very top, right? But it's like towards the bottom because he's offense. So, I mean, that's kind of a, I don't know about that choice. And again, you get this big table. You get this radar chart here. Not any color on the DataViz side. All the graphs that we just looked at all the way down here. And the last thing I'll say about this is that I haven't found a way to just download the data. Or if I want to download this data, I don't know if there's an API in here. It's certainly not anything that I can just click, just download the data as I can on the regular NHL website. In the NHL website, you can download CSV files or you can copy and paste. Can't really do that here as far as I can tell. And the other thing I'd want to do, particularly because of Ovechkin's hot streak that he's currently on, I'd want to change the time. I'd want to say, you know, what's happened over the last week. And you can't really do that here either. So I love that they have more data. I love that stuff is coming out. I love that they have this, I would say, you know, sort of higher density data, because it's got, you know, how much they've been, where, how much they're skating, how far they're skating, the speed of shots, and so on and so forth. But I'd want to be able to download it so that I can make my own comparisons. And, you know, maybe some color. But even if not, even if you say, yeah, it doesn't matter, I can make it on my own, why not make it easier to download the data so I can make this graph with the different colors? So I'm a big fan of more data out there, obviously, but I'd like it to be easier for me to get. But I appreciate that NHL has this new Edge website. I'd encourage you to check it out. I've put the link into the show notes. Let me know if you have other DataViz websites you'd like me, or projects you'd like me to review or critique. Happy to do it. Thanks so much for listening. Thanks so much for watching. Check you next time. Go Caps.